Hi, I'm your host, Al Mercoglana. Welcome to this episode. So you normally know me for hosting What's Going On with Shipping on my YouTube channel. However, I have hosted over on the Maritime History Podcast for the North American Society for Oceanic History. And as one of its three vice presidents, I get to serve on a committee to determine the best maritime and naval books for the year and award them the John Lyman Prize. The John Lyman Book Award is an annual award we give at our conference for the best maritime naval history books in a variety of categories. And what I'd like to do is summarize those that received honorable mention this year and those that were awarded in their respective categories. The first book comes from the category of Canadian Naval and Maritime History, and that is Barry Gough's book. Whoops. Possessing Mears Island, a historian's journey into the past of Clayquot Sound. Barry is a renowned historian, is particularly on British Columbia. And this book was a fantastic read on that. He really brought together British, Canadian, Native American, or indigenous land rights and how they interacted together in the 1850s. Just a great read. Again, one of the things I love about a good history book is it's also a great story. And it's well-written, well-documented. It's got facts. It's got all the things you need. And so if you're interested in one of those things, Possessing Mears Island is a great choice. And I strongly recommend it. Again, it was the John Lyman Book Prize winner for 2021 in the category of Canadian Naval and Maritime History. So in the field of U.S. Naval History, we had a multitude of books that got submitted. I can't tell you how many books we typically get submitted from publishers and authors, anywhere between 40 to 80 books a year. Matter of fact, one of those bookshelves back there, this one over here, you can see some of those books that were submitted and given to us. But this year, we came down to three books in terms of U.S. naval history. So we have two honorable mentions and one award. So the first honorable mention, these are no different, the honorable mentions, is by Claude Berbe, On Wide Seas, the U.S. Navy in the Jacksonian Era. Claude is the director of the U.S. Naval Academy Museum. I know him really well. This book is absolutely great. If you want to fill in the gap between the War of 1812 and the Civil War in terms of U.S. naval history, this is the book for you. It is good. It's not a book about Andrew Jackson. It's about the U.S. Navy in the Jacksonian era. And it really fills in, I would argue, a gap in U.S. naval history. Claude does a great job about it. There's some really interesting things in there, court martials. He's able to weave together a lot of issues, uses some great sources, and really delves into the records. Just a solid book on U.S. naval history. The second honorable mention goes to Ed Marolda, Admirals Under Fire, the U.S. Navy, and the Vietnam War. I have known Ed Marolda for a long time. Ed Marolda, to me, is a godsend to naval and maritime history. When I was a young graduate student, he showed a lot of sympathy to me and really helped direct me in my studies, really pointed me, gave me my first acknowledgement ever in a professional book, and has been there for me for a long time. This book, Admirals Under Fire, is great. It looks at key admirals during the Vietnam War, five of them, and really takes an examination of them, very much in the line of H.R. McMaster's Dereliction of Duty. Just a great book. The book that was awarded the Lyman Prize in Naval and Maritime History is this one by Pete McCord and Michael Bonner, The Union Blockade in the American Civil War, a Reassessment. I've known Mike Bonner, went to school with him at East Carolina. Just a great book, a relook at the Union blockade during the Civil War, gets into the records, gets into the details. Been a lot of looks at blockade runners, but really not a systematic look at the blockade itself, its effectiveness, how it worked, what impact it had on the Confederates. Just a great book. Long time coming, this book. It's been a long time in development. We've known it's coming out for quite a while, but just a great book. So again, the winner for this year for the Lyman Prize in U.S. Maritime History, U.S. Naval History, is Mike Bonner and Pete McCord, The Union Blockade in the American Civil War. We also have a category for U.S. Maritime History, and that tends to be more commercial history than military history. So we had two books in this area. One, the honorable mention, goes to Timothy Walker, Sailing to Freedom, Maritime Dimensions of the Underground Railroad. Again, just a great examination of an area that doesn't get enough attention, probably. And in this particular case, the maritime dimension of the Underground Railroad. Just a great read, really insightful. And again, all these books are academic books. So one of the things we look for when we're doing this is source material. Are they using the academic sources that are out there? Are they using new sources? But at the same time, it's a good read. And really strongly recommend this, especially when you start looking at slavery and the Civil War and the Underground Railroad. The book that we awarded to is one that may seem strange, but man, this is a page turner. And I don't usually say this about this subject in particularly, but the author made this book great. And that's Hannah Farber's Underwriters of the United States, How Insurance Shaped the American Founding. I know, insurance. You would not think this is a book that I have to have. But holy cow, what a great book on a topic that does not get looked at enough. And Hannah Farber put this together, and I love this book. I really did. I found this book really good. And let me be clear, I'm not the only one who chooses this. We have a vast committee that does this. I'm just the face of this right now. We have a great committee that does this. And Hannah Farber's book was a really great one. I enjoyed it immensely. And I think she really demonstrated the crucial role. I recommend this to everybody who just doesn't have an interest in history, because I think it talks about how insurance works in the shipping industry. I have referenced this a lot on my YouTube channel. All right, let's go to the next category. The next category is World Naval and Maritime History. Again, two books in this, an honorable mention and the winner. The honorable mention went to Dane Morrison, East of Good Hope, Early America in a Dangerous World. Oops, see if I got that up there a little better for you. There you go. So looking at, again, early colonization of America. So America is cut loose from the British Empire after the American Revolution. And so the Americans have to find new trade routes. Where do they go? They go east of Good Hope, the Cape of Good Hope, and they are free from mercantilism. They're out exploring. And what Dane Morrison does is look at logs, shipping records, how these American merchants went out to those areas, brought back trade, opened up trade routes, just really creating the beginning of American maritime commerce outside the British mercantilist system, which again was cut loose because of the American Revolution. The winner in this category was Nick Lambert. Unfortunately, I don't have Nick's book here with me because I've got Nick's book packed for a trip I'm going on, because I'm reading it again for the second time to go back through it because it was such a good read. Nick Lambert's book, The Warlords and the Gallipoli Disaster, How Globalized Trade Led Britain to Its Worst Defeat of the First World War. Just an amazing piece of work Nick Lambert does. Nick is an amazing historian across multitude of areas. And this book puts in the context, really changes your look on the Gallipoli campaign of the First World War. A lot of discussion about knocking Constantinople and knocking the Turks out of the war. But as he highlights here, very importantly, it was all about food and wheat in Ukraine and getting it to the marketplace, something that strikes at home right now in a way that we haven't seen before. An excellent read. I enjoyed it. When I read these books for the committee, you go through them fast, you read a lot of them and everything. But one of the things I like to go back to do is go back and secondly read a book and really kind of rip through it and analyze it. And that's what I'm looking forward to with Nick's book. So sorry, I don't have Nick's books here in my hand right now. The next category is Science and Technology in Naval and Maritime. And that goes to Lee Mathers and Norman Polmar for their book, Opening the Great Depths, The Bathyscape Trieste, and Pioneers of Underwater Exploration. So SpaceX, space exploration gets everyone's mind going. NASA, For All Mankind, This goes the opposite way. This is going into the deeps of the ocean and covers the underwater exploration using the bathyscape Trieste. Great read. Holy cow. There are some stories in here where there's problems with the bathyscape that would have, no, there's no way I'd go back in this thing. This is crazy stuff that happens on this voyages. And the people that do it are just amazing in their fortitude and courage. Because I got to say, once something starts leaking at 20,000 feet below the ocean, I'm pretty done. But they kept going. And it's an amazing story. If you get a chance, I strongly recommend that book. We also look at reference works and published primary sources. And here again, we had two great books that I have to say were really tough on the committee to come up with. So we have an honorable mention and a winner. The honorable mention went to Nathan Lipfert on Two Centuries of Maine Shipbuilding. Just a magnificent book in terms of capturing and really discussing the construction of ships in Maine. Visual history, stunning photographs. I mean, just absolutely stunning photographs. Went into the archives, did it again. One of the things we look for reference sources is this something that historians and people are going to, not just the next year, but for decades in the future? And that is one that will definitely do it. On the same side, we had another book that did it in a different area. This was the winner of the Lyman Book Prize. And this is Bill Steele's and Richard Stevenson's Shipbuilding in North Carolina, 1688 to 1918. Just a magnificent piece of research here. Again, very much in that same guise, full of details, all the shipbuilding that took place in North Carolina. Just a magnificent work here of research. And Bill Steele was able to complete that work. And I I'm always in awe of the amount of research that people put into a subject. And when you look at those two books, you'll see the amount of work that goes into it. The last category we have are biographies and autobiographies. And in this case, again, we had some great books that came in, too many of them. Following the Track, World War II, is a whole World War II theme in this subject. Right here is John Hattendorf and Pelham Boyer, To the Java Sea, selections from the diary, report, and letters of Henry E. Eccles, 1940 to 1942. Henry Eccles was on a four-stack destroyer as part of the Asiatic Fleet. This is the fleet that's wiped out at the beginning of World War II in the Pacific, in the Philippines. And this is his letters, his diaries, his reports. You get a firsthand perspective of this. Great book. Again, there's nothing like reading the firsthand account from people who are involved in it. And that's what you get. Henry Eccles, who goes on, writes these books on naval logistics over at the Naval War College. Just an amazing writer. And then finally, the very last one is the winner in the category of biography and autobiography. And that's Paul Stillwell's Battleship Commander, The Life of Vice Admiral Willis A. Lee, Jr. Willis A. Lee was a battleship commander during World War II in the Pacific. Fights probably the classic one-on-one battleship fight of all time. In November of 1942, off the coast of Guadalcanal, he's on board the battleship Washington. He's facing off against the Kirishima. Later in the war, he commands the battleship task forces that are at Philippine Sea, that are off the coast of Surigao Strait, off of Samar Strait, and then misses the Japanese battleships coming out of Leyte Gulf and getting them. Just an amazing account, tragic life story too, I gotta say at the end for it, but just a great account. So those are the winners and the honorable mentions, all of them great books. Strongly recommend if there's a book that you're interested in, go ahead and grab them. I will have the list of all of them in the show notes so that you can go ahead and link to them and take a look at them. Again, we do this annually. We'll have our list posted up at the NASA webpage on these winners and also past winners going back several years. So thanks for tuning in. If you can, please think about becoming a member of the North American Society of Oceanic History. It's a great entity. It's a great organization. We have an annual conference. We have a quarterly publication, The Northern Mariner. We do in conjunction with the Canadian Nautical Research Society up in Canada. It's a great society. We sponsor graduate students coming to our conference to present. So your funds go to not just publish our quarterly journal, but also to help defray costs for our graduate students coming and for giving awards and helping us do these type of book awards. So until our next video, this is Sal signing off.